Let us not, I say to you all, take away from what we saw. And I mean, in a couple of weeks here, what you have seen, you saw a great passing game in week one as they battled the champions down to the last 100 seconds. And then you saw a great run game in week two when you got 195 yards out of that 1-2 punch of Elliott and Pollard. And then you saw the commingling of them both in week three as we readily moved the ball up and down the field, up and down the field, via land or via air. What you saw in that moment was, oh, my God, this really may be one of the seasons that everybody's been talking about. The Cowboys have talent to have. It really may be upon us, and I concur.
Well, Michael, I will say this, that I came on the air yesterday, and I know that many in our profession do not give the Cowboys when credit when it is due. And I think you on occasion might spend a Monday or two with one of them. I am not one of those people. I thought that performance on Monday Night Football, Irv, was one of the best performances I've seen from the Cowboys in the last 20-something years. I don't think, you know, I understand Philadelphia might be down, new coach or whatever, but when you do have somebody like Jalen Hurts making, I believe, career start number 7 or 8 in your house, and you have the ability to jump on the team, and you jump on the team, you should be praised for it. And I thought that was one of the most impressive, balanced performances of a team that's banged up to show off the depth of the team and the drafting knowledge of the team. I thought that was one of the most impressive W's the Cowboys have had in a very long time. Michael.
And it was such a great night, Rich, with all that was happening that night, and to cap it with that great win was just, it was insane. Because that was, man, with Dak returning, that was Dak's return to AT&T Stadium. Now, get this, man, Dak, when Dak come back this time, see, before we had all of these, I believe, about Dak Prescott. And then when he went down, after he went down and we went to what we went through without him, all of that, all of that went away because we know what we were without him. Now you can really appreciate him. And, man, he has taken his game to a level that makes you just say, wow, this is insane and incredible watching him lead this team. They went up and down the field. And now that's on the offensive side, Rich. Let's talk about it on the defensive side. What's most important, and people talk all day about it, you know, man, the Cowboys rank this in defense. They're giving up this many yards. All that's great. And you want to try to lock that down and slow that down. But the reality is nobody takes the ball away more than the Dallas Cowboys. And if you got that on your defense, and nobody takes the ball away more than the Dallas Cowboys in the red zone, and the Cowboys are ranked in the top in the red zone. Now you got a chance at winning.
You're not lying, Irv. They're +5 in that department. That does lead the league through 3 weeks. And as I said yesterday, Michael Irvin here on the Mercedes-Benz Vans phone line on the Rich Eisen Show here right in the middle of the week, that Dak Prescott, 21-26, 230, 238, 3 scores, and then 41 runs for 160 yards. That's it. That's the sweet sauce. That's it. That's the sweet spot. Like, that is the greatest that the Cowboys could wish for coming out of a game. And then that led me to say this, and I obviously want your thoughts on this. This has the chance, with Dak playing as he's playing and looking the way that he's looking and clearly not having those heavy pockets weigh him down, right? And Zeke being at the zenith of maybe his window of as a running back in the NFL, and Amari Cooper leading this receiving core, and a defense that, despite being banged up, is still buzzing around. with a kid in Micah Parsons who looks really good. Is this the best team the Cowboys have fielded since you won with the triplets one, Michael Irvin?
Now, here's the kicker on that, Rich, because I see talent through the years. I see talent. But I don't see the right attitude with the talent. You know what I'm saying? The Cowboys have had some talent. That Romo, T.O., all those teams were talented teams. Mm-hmm. Those were some talented teams. But as I always tell people, you can't win in this game being a team or even being an organization. You got to somehow become a family. And you got to have the personality that builds family. And they and as talented as those teams were, they didn't have the personality that builds family. Dak, these guys, they do. And the Michael Parsons, these guys, they know how to build football family, and that's what they're working towards building. And that makes a huge difference because everybody has talent. It's who's connected, who's most together. That's who's going to win right here and right now. And we're seeing the Cowboys finally putting both of those together. I thought they were wilt. In Tampa, I was like, man, that's going to be a tough spot to go back in there and play Tampa. They didn't wilt. They played hard. Then the Chargers going in. So, you know what I mean? So now their personality and their hunger is matching finally the talent that we always saw all the time. So I don't know. I think they may have had even more talented teams, but they didn't have the right people with the right personalities to make that team a family.
So is that a maybe from you on
no,
that
no,
question?
No. It's a definite. It's a definite when you combine the importance of both of them. Now, if you're just talking, is this the most talented team only, then I may even say no. But if you're saying it's the most talented team and I'm incorporating the ability to bring people together as a talent, then I say by far.
They just seem to have the, again, it's so much of a knee-jerk reaction potentially because it's just three games, but you do see it. I do see it, and I was skeptical of it. I was skeptical of it.
Good three games.
No, I know that, and they are, you know, opponents that were either defending champs, raising a banner, or a young up and coming team with a terrific quarterback and a bunch of talented players playing in front of fans for the first time in their new home, and then, you know, a division opponent. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.